he's known throughout the land. But little know the story of how this great saint came to be. So I'll sing to you a tale of Colorado's history.
Best back of the day. You see, every time I tell this story, I keep getting my facts a little bit mixed up. But there is one fact I know for certain. The folks who are going to be helping me tell the story today are all true professionals. They're going to be showing the skills and traditions handed down through generations of one, two men and women. Now, in order to tell an accurate story of Colorado's early days, you know, there's bound to be some gunplay. So with all the live ammo flying, we got to insist that everybody here please refrain from smoking and keep all the aisleways clear. Unless you want to become part of the show. So this is the genuine story of how Colorado became a state. Sort of. And the most important thing is just to have a good time. Now, are you folks up for a good time? Well, it all started way back in 1850. We'll give or take a year. When the only ones to bring this land were men of little fear. Little brains, kind of hard to figure which. Now, they were mostly fur trappers and traders with names you might remember, like Lily Vasquez or Kit Carson. There's a few you probably never heard of, like this old prospect. Now, he goes by the name of Old Horace Tabor. This man would surf through desert heats and mountains air so cold until the day he stubbed his toe.
What tarnation?
And he discovered,
no! There's gold in Colorado!
Well, they just spent a handful of nuggets, but it was enough to convince old Horace to keep on looking for that mother lode.
Thank you.
person. Why, he just as soon shoot you as look at you. He'd kick a man when he was down. Why, he'd even take candy from a baby. In other words,
he was a bad guy.
Obviously not the type you'd want to head your local welcome wagon.
So what do you think we have to do about
this guy? It was clear that law and order was a necessary trait.
Hang
on! Colorado soon become the newest Indian state. So a territorial governor was sent to tame a lion. His name is William Galvin.
Can he do it?
Yes, he can! Excuse for you and being a pincy. Well, he was born, the doctor slapped his paw. Say, is the governor okay in there?
Yeah,
yeah. That's strange, huh? Guess he didn't make the stage. And here we had this big celebration planned in his honor with roping, rotting, and dancing. Well, maybe this sorry-looking tenderfoot knows what happened. Excuse me, son. Have you seen our new governor? I'm William Gilpin.
Well, now, ain't that nice? Say, went and got yourselves a store-bought gun. And he is one fearful-looking sight.
You laugh now, Charlie Harrison, but the governor here is going to see to it that Colorado becomes a state.
Over my dead body. He folks are just as loco as old Horace here looking for a mother load. He ain't no kind of governor. He's a greenhorn. And if I was you, I'd hang him.
Boys, now hold it! We can't just up and hang this man for no reason.
Why not?
Well, because this is the old West. Where every man has a chance to prove himself. Let this poor misfit of a man change into something more suited to a social environment. Let him try to fit in and meet your families. Let him strive to become the kind of governor you know you deserve.
Oh, that was beautiful.
And if he fails, well, then we'll hang him. Yeah! Get some new bots, let's go on a celebration. That governor, he'll be okay, let's not forget we planted it. The biggest shining year for setting up new town to build it. Grab your pulse and trust in you, we'll use it all down here. Have some fun and you'll agree it's a new town to build it. Express turn horse work and a horse play with skill and finesse. There's our main name. Watch it out, ladies. Back in the sound game. Show the folks how we're doing on this side. Thank you. Scalpel Tricia's bottle man ability.